Hello, all my friend from Taiwan, especially from the Holistic School. I'm honored to talk in your celebration of the 25th anniversary. That I hope that this 25 was only the beginning of a big journey that we will do together to bring a lot of innovation to the world of education, and I think this is the need today. So I glad to be part of you. So I begin with my story that I built 33 years ago. I built another school in Israel, and I call it Democratic School. And the major idea of the school was that we need to live democracy at school. If we want to be a democratic society, democracy needs to begin at school. And that's the major idea of what I tried to do 33 years ago. Today, we have more than 2,700 schools all over the world in more than 60 countries. And it's happened by that more than 25 years ago, I built international conference that I call it IDEC, and people from different countries begin to come. And that's also the situation that I begin to meet people from Taiwan. And I think my big learning about that what happened in Taiwan happened in the 2016 when you invite me to the EPIDEC, Asia Pacific International Democratic School, and to me it was very interesting, and I learned how far away you build these ideas of democratic education in Taiwan, and I meet a lot of good friends there, and I think today Taiwan is one of the central places that try to build a new kind of education, that democratic education is in the central of all of what we are trying to do. When I say democratic school, and when I say that we have so much democratic school, I want to say another very important thing. All the democratic school is also different, because if you run the school democratically, it cannot be that your school will be similar to another school. But in all the democratic school, we can find four major ideas that it's running in all the democratic school. The practices of these ideas, school do differently, but we can find these four practice ideas. The first one is a democratic community. In all the democratic school, we make decision together. You can find in all the democratic school, student, staff member, and parents making decision together. It's in a different way. In some places, it's only student. In some places, it's student with staff. Some places bring parents. Some do it by voting of 51%. Some people do it by consensus. But in all the democratic school, you can see the process of making decision and later running this decision. And if someone breaks the decision, we have mediation committee, we have a judicial committee. So the school look like a microcosmos of democratic country. The second things that you can see in all the democratic schools is self-direct learning. It's mean that in all the democratic school, choosing what you are learning is very important. We believe that people is different. And if they are different, they need a different learning plan. And that's we see we have in all the democratic school. Another very important thing is here is the dialogue-based relationship. In most of the democratic school, the connection between adults and students, it's very close, very dialogue. It's not a hierarchic meeting. It's very dialogue discussion. The four major idea that you can find in democratic school is human rights based content. So we look from on the content that we look, teach at school, also from nationality, way of the view of the what our nationality think, but also from the point of view of human rights, from the rights of women, from the rights of the minorities. Human rights is the central of what we are doing at school, what we study at school. And we can say in one sentence that in democratic school, we live democracy and live human rights inside the school. Today, after 33 years that we run democratic schools, I can't, you know, before we call democratic school, it was alternative free school in the last 100 years. But the name democratic school come only in the last 33 years ago. And I think it's not by luck. Because more and more countries around the world begin to call themselves democratic countries. But they adapt the same structure of education that prepare people to live in undemocratic countries. So they take the structure of education that the teacher tell the student what to do, how to do, and check them if they done it for until they are 18. So the student practice how to do exactly what people tell them to do. And then when they're 80s, they tell them, now choose your life. And we say, no, it's not working like this. Democracy needs to grow up inside school, step by step. And that's the major idea of democratic education. And we say democratic education is the missing piece of the puzzle of democracy at all. That what we see problem of democracy today in the world, it's because we have no connection between the education and the ideas of democracy. So let's go back out to the beginning of the century to John Dewey, that he began to think about the connection about democracy and education, and see what he say. He say democracy has been a new every generation. And education is its midwife. It means that John Dewey say to us, it cannot be that in one side it will be democracy and the idea of democracy, and the another side education that prepare to another thing. The two major ideas need to connect. And now I want to take you to school, but by example that I like to give. Think that this cloud is represent the cloud of knowledge. So we have here a lot of knowledge, and it's also doubling itself every half a year. And you see these people here, this is us. We are different. We are different. Think, it's wonderful. We are different. I don't know, some people believe that we create by God. Some people believe that we create by nature. Some people believe that they don't know who create us. And it's not, from my point of view, all the three ideas or 3,000 ideas, it's okay. The reality is that we are different. So someone that create us decide that we will be different, or it doesn't decide, it's happened that we are different. In this case, I think this is wonderful, because if I imagine that we all were the same, from my point of view, it was really catastrophe. Because, for example, all of you were Yaakov. What we can talk, all of us Yaakov. And we go in different places in the world and everyone is Yaakov. This is boring world. I think what is moving the world is that we are different. This is something that moves the world. And when we are different, things create new ideas in the stress between us, in the because we are different. We say in democratic education, different is beautiful. But something happened in the middle of the industrial age. In the middle of the industrial age, they build a lot of factories and they need people to work as robots in these factories. You remember Charlie Chaplin from the modern time. They need to be like a robot. So they say, oh, we need to build a factory that take the people that they are different and make from them a robot. And this factory, they call it a skull. So they build a room of 50 meter and put their group of students from 20 to 50, depending on the countries, and they teach them the same subject with the same teacher in the same time, and they believe that they become the same. So they say, everyone, now it's not good that you are here in the area of knowledge. You need to get inside this box. And they say, oh, you, please, everyone, get inside the box. And this is school. It's very, very difficult to see the uniqueness of every child. I was 10 years a teacher. It's really difficult. But if you look inside the box, you make a zoom in to the box, you see that it's not a box. It's a pyramid. The excellent student is here and the weak people is here. And I think this is the terrible, terrible things that exist in the world. That you learn that it exists excellent people and weak people. And you understand that these weak people can be excellent in another area. They are only weak in the box, in the way that the box is working. So, and to me, as an Israeli and a Jewish person, it's not working. It's not working because the person that we think that is the genius that was in the last 100 years, you know, Albert Einstein, he never was a good student. Not in elementary school, not in high school, not in a university. And Albert Einstein teach us something that I think it's so important. More than the relative law that he found. He say that everybody is a genius. He say, no, don't think that only 2% is a genius. Everyone is a genius. And if everyone is a genius, we build totally new school. Not a school that will find the 2% of genius or the 20% that excellence. The school that look the uniqueness of the genius area of every student. And Albert Einstein continue and say, he say that, but if you judge a fish by its abilities to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that is a stupid. Wow. He said to us, you, the educator, walk carefully, because if you will focusing about the pyramid and you will find the 20% excellence, you will destroy the 80%. And you the world will lose the beautiful things that this 80% bring us. So what we are doing in democratic education, we go out from the box and look for the excellent area of every student. My good friend Sir Ken Robinson, he don't call it a genius area, he call it the element. What it's mean, the element? It's the place that give you the best chance to success in the future, and it's the area that connect your talent and your motivation. This is the best place to prepare you to the future. But this education system is very expensive, because you need to build a learning plan to every student. So you will need a lot of teachers. What we are doing, we stop to use this gas and we begin to use alternative energy. What is alternative energy in the field of democratic education? We say the traditional school get money from the government or from the parents and run the school. The democratic school is running by the power of the student. Students don't come empty to school. They bring with them a lot of knowledge. If we don't use the knowledge that the student bring, why we do it? It's so important, this knowledge. Also teachers. Teachers bring much more knowledge than what they teach. Parents bring a lot of knowledge. Free materials in the internet bring us a lot of knowledge today, more and more. Organizations that run in our society, people in our society, can come and help us to do, to help the student to learn what they need. For example, people that go to pension and they can come to school. A lot of people can come and help us at school. So when we say democratic education, we say that we think that everyone is unique, and we think different is beautiful, and we think that everyone needs to find his uniqueness, and to find his uniqueness, he cannot find it in the box. In the box, maybe 20% will find their uniqueness. We need to use all the knowledge that available to us. And in this case, we cannot build the idea of pyramid that teacher teach student. We need to do it that everyone is a teacher and everyone is a student. That we know that it's the best way to learn something. The best way to learn something is to teach it. So how we move from a pyramid to a network, or why we need to move from pyramid to network? Because if we live for a long time in a pyramid, we begin to believe that all the world, our head become a pyramid, and we believe that the universe around us is full with pyramid. What it mean? If your head become a pyramid, when you meet someone else, immediately you begin to think, oh, he is from the up of the pyramid or down of the pyramid. You don't see the uniqueness of everyone. You all the time judge the people around you. Where they are in the pyramid, and if I want to be connect to them. And we want to give our student totally new way of looking on the world, to see in every person around them the uniqueness. In this case, how we do it at school? At school, this is the old traditional school. The teacher comes with the blue good materials, and he thinks that all the student is empty. And then he take the materials and teach it to all the student, and this is successful school. In democratic education, the teacher comes with the same blue materials, but he know that every student bring another color. And then he need to learn. We have the close connection, a dialogue connection with the student. So we begin to learn the unique color of every student. And then we find, oh, this student is very good in mathematics, so he can teach him. And he very good in English, he can teach him. So we build the teacher build a network. And this is the next note, that it's a learning community, that everyone is a student teacher and everyone is a teacher. So that's very important, one thing that we do in democratic education, and we're moving from pyramid to a network. The second thing I want to show you, how we move from the box that I call it the encyclopedia box. The encyclopedia, it was a great idea. Let's put all the knowledge in one book, but it's a great idea in the 18th century, not today. Today we say, how we bring any knowledge to school, and give the student opportunity to find their uniqueness, to find the area that they can be excellent. In this case, this is, you remember the box. So how we find all this knowledge here? Because here I have a teacher, but here no. In this case, we begin to use the internet. Teacher can use the internet, and especially the MOOC. What is MOOC? MOOC is something that makes a lot of change in our world today. It's a very good courses that get to the internet by best universities in the world. We call it MOOC because it's massive open online courses. And today, most of the universities in the world give MOOCs, but it's not only universities. Today, more and more organization that specialize in different things bring the best courses in any subject that to the school, and it's free and open to everyone. So the problem is that if you take this MOOC by your computer alone at home, only 4% success to finish these courses. We say between 4 to 20%. But then I go to the Ministry of Education in Israel and say, let's begin to teach MOOCs in our high school. And he say to me, Yaakov, it's 4%. The newspaper will kill me. I tell him, no. You remember the way that we learn in the network, that everyone is a student and everyone is a teacher? This model, we call it auto MOOC. It's let's make the MOOC social. What it mean? Let's make that we will see the MOOC, but we learn as a team. As a team model. And in this case, like a group will go to learn together and they will teach one another. In this case, we now have 88% success. So I want to explain. We have student in a very difficult area. For example, Bedouin in the desert, that they can take courses from Stanford University, and we end with 88% because they study to learn that everyone is a student and everyone is a teacher. That's example of such a school. You can see five students and they have one computer and they see the lecture, they have the first chapter, they finish it, and you see the cards. Cards say, Red cards, I doesn't understand. Green, I understand and I can teach. Yellow, I have question. And then they begin to talk with between themselves and teach one another until everyone is green. They cannot have, find answers. They can go to another table and ask other people in the classroom. So we built a network that helped every student to learn and teach, to be a teacher and learner in the same time. And you see, this is look very informal. And that's also changed the school, the physical way of the school. This is the traditional physical school with the teacher in the blue, and he moved the blue to everyone. But if the teacher come and he know that every student is different, why the school need to run like this? We can make a circle. But if it's a circle, why to make only one whiteboard? We can make a whiteboard all over the school, the classroom, sorry. And then we break to a group and everyone, a teacher and everyone is a student. You can see here student, our student in our school, that they sit and teach one another. Or sit in the table and teach one another. Or another group that it's 80 students in this classroom and they teach one another. And it can be also in the young elementary school that students teach one another. So, and in this case, come the coronavirus. And I think the coronavirus do something very, very interesting. Because if this circle represent the innovation, what we want to do, we have two power that work on this innovation. One is this blue one, and it's the innovation have the power to be like the it was in the past. And the second one is go and try to be like the dream of the democratic education. In this case, something happened in the coronavirus. Someone come and cut the power of doing what it was because it stopped to work. And then the push to be as a learning community become much more reality. And in this case, one day we stopped to go to school and we, what we can say see today that more and more school around the world found that the ideas of democratic education work especially now. And in the beginning, it was the big wave of distance learning. And we in the field of democratic education, we begin to celebrate because we can find students from all over the world, not only from my school, begin to learn together. And we use this symbol, green, red, and blue, like you see in the card. We can study together something and then someone say, I don't understand, and something someone teach him, and things like this. Today, I think most of the world go to the hybridic school. Hybridic school, it's mean that part of the learning will be inside school and part will be on the distance learning. And that's from my point of view, if we understand the ideas of democratic education, that the school can live democracy and give power not only to the student, also to the teacher, and also to the principal. In this case, we can make a lot of connection today in the world and make the world much more closer to one another. So to me, all the people that believe in democratic education, and I think that we are today something like 10 million students that involved in the area of democratic education in the world, we can make the world much safer. Because the idea of the pyramid is, from my point of view, is a very dangerous situation. Because it's not only that I am better than you. It's also that my country is better than you. It's my family is better than your family. It's become place of power and dangers. When we say that different is beautiful, I think it's, and when we say that different is beautiful, it's saying that I have I want to be myself, and I hope that you will see my uniqueness and give me to be myself, and I will see your uniqueness, and I appreciate your uniqueness. And when I say it, it's in the beginning, it's to be yourself as a student, and then to be yourself as a culture. I don't want all the culture in the world to think who is better and who is worse. I don't want that we will think who is the best countries and who is the less not good countries. I think we want to be push the idea that different is beautiful, and give the option to everyone to be himself and go with this as far as he can. And to me, this is, I feel that this is also will be. And in the end, I want to say to me, it's a great, great honor that you invite me to your 25th anniversary of the Holistic School. I want to say and send my big hug to all my friends in Taiwan. I feel we are partner in something very big that happened today in the world. And I so much love and appreciate what you are doing in Taiwan. And I hope the coronavirus crisis will disappear, and soon we will meet one another face to face. So good luck and enjoy your anniversary. See you soon. Bye.